Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about Byte Beauty's brand new foundation. It is the first that they have launched in their line, and I'm going to give you some information that I think is important for you to consider before you spend your money on this foundation. To be clear, this is not a review video. This is not a wear test. I do not have this foundation in hand. I did not put it on my own skin, nor would I. I wouldn't purchase it with my own money. So if you are here thinking that you're going to see me give a review on it because I have actually tested it on my skin, this is not the video for you. Instead, this is something that I believe it is important for you to know, to arm yourself with, so that you can make an educated, good decision, hopefully, when you are deciding whether or not to spend your own money on a foundation that has certain attributes that I think you may not like to have in a foundation. So if you are someone who has been considering whether or not to buy this foundation, especially based on the relatively glowing reviews that other people are giving and the ranting and raving by some very large beauty YouTubers, then make sure you keep watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel by hitting that subscribe button, follow Allure Beauty on Instagram, and of course, if you haven't seen the latest video, I believe that was a swatch application video for Milani's brand new liquid blushes, and there are 6 shades there, so I'll link that in the upper right-hand corner. If you missed that video, you're gonna wanna watch it. All right, let's get to talking about Byte Beauty's new foundation. So the foundation that I'm talking about is called the Changemaker Supercharged Micellar Foundation. It is currently available to purchase through Byte Beauty or through Sephora. It retails for $39.50. You probably know Byte Beauty started out as a lip product company. They concentrate on having their agave lip balms. They have a line of colored lip products, and there was a lot of excitement and buzz around them moving out into the space of base products. So there are 3 main issues that I have with this foundation. I'm gonna go in order of increasing level of concern, I guess you could categorize them as. In fact, the first 2 things are really not big deals, but they are things that bother me a little bit, and so I'm gonna include them here. The first thing is this whole it being a clean foundation. Now, I don't really know, I don't think anyone really knows what that term is. Sephora does have a list of requirements in order to categorize something on their website as a clean beauty product. But if you look at that list of things, it's not really clear why certain ingredients make something unclean and why having other things in a product doesn't make something unclean. So it's just a very gray space in general. It's not particular to Byte Beauty's products or this particular foundation. It's more the whole concept, which I think is more of a fad maybe, or just a trend, a marketing thing that companies are clinging onto to make people feel better that they may be buying something that is better for their health or their skin. When in reality, the things that are the criteria that are used to define something as clean and not clean don't seem to actually correlate with ingredients that are good for your skin and not good for your skin, which will tie into the 3rd most important point once I get there. For example, in order to be clean at Sephora, the products must be formulated without things like parabens. Don't know why parabens make something unclean. It's a type of way that you preserve a product. The product, I guess, could have a bunch of other preservatives, but because parabens has gotten a bad reputation without the scientific backing for it, all of a sudden it's something that's required to not have in order to be a clean product. It can't be formulated with retinyl palmitate. Again, I don't know why that makes something unclean. There are individual people who just may have a personal preference to avoid those things, or they may have some sort of skin allergy or sensitivity, which I totally respect, but that's not something that should be universally applied to everyone as a label of being unclean. If I'm allergic to peanuts, that doesn't make peanuts unclean or bad food. It means that I need to, when I'm going out in the grocery store looking for food, I need to be educated enough and take the caution to look at the ingredients list, make sure there aren't any peanuts in it, not made in a factory that has peanut powder or peanut dust going around. It has to be formulated without hydroquinone, a known ingredient that can help with discoloration. It's very effective for that. It cannot have any undisclosed synthetic fragrances. I don't know why a product would suddenly become clean just because you disclosed that it had a bad ingredient, like fragrance. That doesn't make sense to me. Anyway, I could go on, but I'm not going to. You get my point. The second thing that I take a little bit of an issue with is the shade range. I'm sure other people have pointed this out too. If I've counted correctly, there's a total of 32 shades. If you look at the swatches and the depths of each individual shade, I would categorize maybe two of these 32 shades as truly deep shades. The rest are fair, light, or medium shades. Maybe you could categorize some of them as tan or medium deep, but in terms of a truly deep shade, I think it's honestly just one. I think if you are a little more lenient, maybe two of the shades are suited for truly deep skin tone. Now, I don't want to make a huge issue out of this because I think there is a fair point to say this is the brand's very first foundation launch. They don't know how popular it will be. They don't know how many units they're gonna sell. So they may just want to put out a subsampling, and then if it is very popular, they may expand the shade range. Even that I feel like is subject to a little bit of the same issues when you have such a disproportionate percentage of the 32 shades you did release being not suitable for people of color, but hoping for the best that they will increase the range for medium to deep skin tones. The third thing is really the thing that I take issue with and the reason why I wanted to make this video. And that is that this foundation contains ingredients that are not good for the skin. And I feel like so many large beauty influencers, whatever you wanna call them, I don't consider myself one of those, but whatever you wanna categorize people who make videos and promote products, it is one of my pet peeves that there are so many people with so much influence out there who do not take the time or responsibility to be cautious about what they promote. People with millions of viewers and followers who will say, this is a great skincare product, this foundation is wonderful for your skin, and they don't even know what they're talking about. They don't even try to know what they're talking about. You know, I'm sure that I get some things wrong too, but at the least, I take the time and energy to try to research what I'm telling you is good or not good to put on your skin, all over your skin, the largest organ in your body, and it really irks me to see such big influencers willy-nilly say, oh, I like this skincare product because I like the way it smells, or I just like the way it feels. Skincare is not about how it makes you feel. Skincare is about, is it good for your skin? Does it do something that's effective? Sure, it may be an additional great point for something you put all over your face to also give you some sort of emotional experience, but if there's things in the product that are going to be damaging to you, I think that it is the responsibility of myself, and I would hope other people recommending products to you, to take the time and educate themselves, at least try to educate themselves, and take the responsibility to communicate those things to you. And I want to be clear, this is not some sort of rant or hate video against any specific YouTuber, anything like that. This is a general thing that has been in existence for years in the YouTube community, and I'm glad to see more influencers, I hate using that word, but more people making videos who are taking the time to educate themselves. I just think that that trend needs to continue. So what is it that's in this foundation that isn't good for your skin? Fragrance. If you look at the ingredients list, about a little more than halfway through the ingredients list is fragrance. Now, you make your own decision. Some people, they are aware that fragrance is an irritant to the skin. It's not good for the skin. In no situation is it ever an ingredient that helps your skin. But if you care more about liking the way that a product you use smells, and you are okay with the risks associated or the damage associated long-term on your skin with putting fragrance on it, especially all over, then absolutely, you presumably are an adult. I'm sure some of you are underage watching, but most of you are adults. You can make your own decision. But if you do make that decision, it should be because it's an educated one. It's an informed one. And you know that you're making a certain choice where some of the ingredients in what you're buying may not be good for you. And to tie it back to the first point about this being a clean product, in no situation is fragrance clean. So I don't really understand how those two things jive with each other. It doesn't matter if it's a synthetic fragrance or if it's a natural fragrance, another phrase that I think is very problematic in the skincare and beauty industry. Something being natural doesn't make it good for your skin. Equally so, something that is manufactured in a lab doesn't make it bad for you. In fact, some of the best skincare ingredients, I would say almost all of the best skincare ingredients, are manufactured. They're tinkered by chemists. They are extracted from things and concentrated, as opposed to just sitting in your kitchen and trying to rub a kiwi on your face. There are lots of natural things that are terrible for us. Anthrax occurs naturally in the environment. Doesn't mean you want to be exposed to it or integrate it into your daily life. I did notice a good number of people when Bite Beauty was promoting the launch of this foundation on their Instagram page. People did point out, people, consumers were noticing that, hey, there's fragrance in this, you know, how much fragrance in there is in there, where does the fragrance come from? And I actually tried to also comment and ask, I said, do you know what the reason is that Bite Beauty is adding fragrance to this product? I, of course, didn't get a response. Bite's cut and paste response to all of those comments is, we use naturally derived scents and less than 1% synthetic fragrances. Okay, well, I'm glad that there's not even more fragrance in the product, but there's no reason to have any fragrance. So chuck the fragrance. The product should function exactly the same, and it won't be damaging to your skin. In addition to that, the foundation contains limonene as the very last ingredient. So there is a very, very small amount of it. So it's very possible that this actually will not create any significant noticeable damage to your skin in the long run. But limonene is also an irritant, volatile compound. It's not good to put all over your face. Oh, and the other thing is the whole micellar foundation, I think many people have pointed this out, doesn't really make sense to me. And that may just be complete personal lack of understanding. So please don't take this as me saying that Bite Beauty is wrong and they shouldn't have named it this. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it seems strange to me to call something a micellar foundation, because my understanding of micellar and micellar waters are things used to cleanse the skin, including of things like foundation. So I just think it's an odd thing to call a foundation or associate a foundation with. Bite Beauty saying that the term micellar communicates that it's very skin-like. So I don't know. Oh, I actually have another huge issue. So number four, I lied. Four of them, not three. And this one bothers me, I don't know if it bothers me even more than the fragrance that's been added, but the fact that the rave reviews on Sephora, all those five-star reviews, if you take a look, actually not now, because there are more recent reviews actually in the past hour or so that I think are more balanced. But when I originally looked at the reviews and I was trying to figure out, you know, what people are thinking of the foundation and how it looks and wears, that was 3 or 4 days ago, maybe a week ago, I'm not sure, but at least 3 or 4 days, maybe a week or so ago, they were almost, I think with the exception of one of them that I can remember, they were all five-star reviews, and they were all people who received free product. Now, I don't take issue with people receiving free product. That is a marketing thing. That's something brands do. That's something brands always will do. And I don't have an issue with that. I think that's a good way to get people to use the product, have an opinion beforehand so that they can share those opinions with other people. What I do take issue with is that I am suspicious of all these five-star reviews coming from people who have received free product and who don't mention the fact that there's fragrance in the product and that there are damaging ingredients in the product. And these reviews are all up right as the foundation launches, which floods the list of reviews and the star rating from people who have not purchased the product themselves, gives the impression to the consumer who may not be looking individually at each review to see if they've received the product, and convinces them that people have a uniformly unbiased view of what the product is actually like. And what I'm just noticing, just looking at now, is the more recent reviews being things like 3-star reviews, 2-star reviews, 1-star reviews, and people commenting on the fact that it does have fragrance in it. And again, I don't want this to just be a ranting video, although I'm sure that's the way it comes off. What I really am aiming to do is to share the information so that you can do with it what you want to, so that regardless of what choice you end up making, that at least you have information that I feel like a lot of people may be missing and didn't realize they didn't have before they purchase something. And final thing that I want to emphasize, this is not a hate video or a rant video against Bite Beauty. I do not have an issue with brand in general. If I did, I would tell you. This is very specific to the circumstances of the launch of this foundation, the apparent hype and raving that's going on about it, and information like I feel people are entitled to and should have that I don't feel is being put out there. I want to end the video on a hopefully positive note, although I think being armed with information is always a positive thing. So I want to give you a recommendation for a foundation that I have been using consistently that I think matches a lot of the claims that Bite Beauty is making about this foundation that I think a lot of you may like if you're looking for the features that Bite Beauty is promoting about this new micellar foundation. So looking at their description of their foundation, it says a clean, we've already covered that part, long-wearing foundation with gentle micellar technology that mimics skin texture for a natural, flawless finish. They say it's medium coverage, and the formulation is a liquid formulation that's good for all skin types and that includes antioxidants. So here are the main things I see they're saying are good about this foundation: that it's long-wearing, that it's clean, which I'm going to set aside, that it mimics the skin texture so that it looks very natural on the skin, and it says buildable to medium coverage and contains antioxidants. So this is a foundation that I mentioned in January's What's New in Beauty video. I'll link that in the upper right-hand corner if you missed it. It was an epic review of things that have just launched on the market. So if you haven't seen it, please go check it out. This is a foundation that I was wearing in that video. I'm also wearing it in this video, and that I just have really been enjoying. This is not sponsored by Undone Beauty. I do not get any affiliate link or commission off of you purchasing this from whatever website you can find it. I don't know if it's available outside of Undone Beauty's own website, but I have no monetary interest in you purchasing this foundation. It's just something that I think fits the bill of the marketing claims of Bite Beauty, but doesn't have fragrance, doesn't have alcohol, doesn't have volatile ingredients. So this is Undone Beauty's Unfoundation Glow Tint plus Skin Loving Coconut Extract. It says right on the bottle, light coverage, which I agree with, although I think once you layer it, you can build it up to something approaching medium coverage, which is why I feel like it matches that claim by Bite Beauty on their foundation. It is vegan and cruelty-free. You get 1.13 ounces, 32 grams, and it retails only for $14, less than half of what the Bite Beauty one costs. Now, this is a reformulated product, so just make sure if you're not purchasing from Undone Beauty's website, I think it's also available through Amazon or other retailers, just make sure that you're getting the new version, because I don't know what the old version, the original version, is like. I can't speak to whether that's good or not. The color I wear is Buttercream Medium Light, which is 430. This foundation only comes in 14 shades, so that is, I would have a similar criticism of that, although obviously Undone Beauty is not as widely known. It's not as big of a company as Bite Beauty, so their capability to really release a huge shade range is minimized, but I would like it if they did have a wider range of shades. Hopefully if this becomes really popular, they can do that. I do feel like because it is a more light to, if you build it up approaching medium coverage, that the shades can be more forgiving because they're not as pigmented. But this looks very natural on the skin, extremely skin-like. It wears super well throughout the day, whether I set it with powder or not. And in addition to not containing actively harmful ingredients like alcohol or fragrance, it has some nice, good for you skincare ingredients. Not a ton of them, but it does contain a good amount of glycerin. There is also a little bit of coconut oil. That's the very last ingredient listed. And there's also vitamin E in here. So that would be my recommendation instead of spending approaching $40 for the Bite Beauty foundation. This is an improvement in terms of the ingredients. It's an improvement in terms of the amount you get for the price, and you're getting the same benefits that are claimed by the Bite Beauty foundation. If you want to see footage of me applying this foundation, layering it, if you want to see what the finish looks like, shots up close of how it looks, that footage is included in that video for January's What's New in Beauty. So I hope that this video was helpful to you, even if it wasn't, even if you weren't interested. I hope that it was entertaining. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch. And as always, I'll see you